It is a very unfortunate and a sad incident which happened in Tamil Nadu, Kallakurichi district, where more than 50 people till today have died due to the consumption of illicit arak, or what you call as hooch. And I think the deaths will be more in the coming days, because even this morning 5 people have been admitted. They just came, walked to the hospital. And out of 5, 3 are in a little difficult situation. Last year, in Vilupuram district and Kanjipuram district, 29 people died due to this illicit arak. And that time, Chief Minister Mr. Stalin had said that we will eradicate this illicit arak culture itself with an iron hand and iron fist, all the dialogue he was doing. This time, it happened in Kallakurichi. And here you have this hills called Kalvarayan Hills, where the tribals, they have been preparing this illicit arak for the last 40 years. And everybody knows that. They have been protected by the DMK's MLA. He's a 5-time MLA. For him, he's got 30,000 votes in the hills, and he protects them. And we have another one MLA from DMK, who protects the suppliers. This guy protects the manufacturers. Illicit arakers, distillers. This guy protects the suppliers. When they protect, if they go to the police, they're caught in the police, they go help them out. This is what is happening. So, Chief Minister should take full responsibility. This is another incident like this shouldn't happen. This is what he said last year, but this time it's happened. Second thing is, we want 2 ministers to be dismissed. One is Mr. Muthuswamy. He's in charge of enforcement. And second is the charge minister here. This district doesn't have a minister by itself. So there's a charge minister, Evi Velu. He is the Minister of Highways and PWD. He's a very influential person. And these MLAs are all his proteges. So, and now they have announced a CBCID inquiry, which is nothing going to happen. I will assure you. They will pick up about 20 people and they say these are the people responsible. They won't pick up any politicians. Because politicians are fully involved in this. And these ruling party politicians are neck deep in this. So this is what we want is, we want a CBI inquiry. Second is, we want these 2 ministers to be dismissed. And then we want these 2 MLAs, who are district secretaries, to be arrested, to be charged. Because inquiry won't be a fair inquiry. And then what I want is, FIR should be filed against the SP and the collector as well. Then only this will deter future incidences like this. Because the SP has been suspended, the collector has been transferred, that's all. The collector has misleaded these people. If the collector has said that this is because of illicit arak, people would have taken notice and come to the hospital sooner. Because of that, this methanol poisoning is where you have to have an antidote within 10 hours to 30 hours. Or worst come worst, you have to give ethanol within the 10 hours. People came after 24 hours. Because the SP said that this is not illicit alcohol. So SP should be charged. The collector said. The collector should be charged. FIR should be put against the collector. He is responsible for more than 50 deaths today. So these things has to be done. And the basic problem in Tamil Nadu is Tamil Nadu has got the highest revenue through alcohol run by government shops, Tasmak shops. It has destroyed hundreds of thousands, millions of families. It had made youngsters. Today, there was a youngster who was admitted this morning. He's 21 years old. And he says that the last 6 years, every morning 4:30, he starts drinking. He's 21 years. He's been admitted today because he drank this illicit arak 3 days before. He and his father. So this culture is what you call Dravidian culture. They say the Dravidian model. This is the Dravidian model. You make youngsters alcohol addicts. So this is something where the Chief Minister has to act immediately. It is a shame for us. A shame for Tamil Nadu. And I see that nearly 120 people have been admitted. This methanol poisoning will take effect even after 1 week, 10 days. So you need to keep them in observation for more than at least minimum 10 days to 15 days. And there is no antidote here. If you give an antidote, at least you could have helped, you could have saved at least 20, 30 people. And the same thing happened last year. They said that no, the antidote we will get from abroad, we'll keep it ready. Where's the antidote? Femiprazole antidote.